up together, we're going to try and get them synchronised together. So we want to bring them back up the top here, really. And what we're going to try and do is keep them in the in front position here, and we're going to walk backwards and try and keep them together as we do our twists. Right, so we're going to take 3 paces and then do a twist, and there we go. That's an anti-clockwise spin. Got that? Right. And that's just going which way, you'll know. Right. Anti-clockwise. Twist. That way. Got that bit? No. There we go. Right, so synchronized team, here we go. Go 3 paces back. Here we go. Go. 1, 2, 3. Twist. 1, 2, 3. Twist. And again. Twist. Good. Now we can also do that at a distance. So what we're now going to do is we're going to send the dogs walking backwards. Pogo, come in front. Walk back. Walk back. Now this makes it a bit more difficult for the dog. Walk back. Walk back. Whirly. 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 Down. Good. Can he cross paws? We can't cross paws, but what we can do, walk back. Whirly. Sit. Sit. Both. Right, well done. Give you a little round of applause. Good. Very nice. Now, everything that we do with the dogs comes from obedience. And Mary's going to demonstrate some left-hand heel work, and I'm going to pop Pogo onto the right-hand side, Pogo right. Now, when we're working the dogs, everything comes from the obedience. Levi there is top obedience dog in the country. He's won a lot of tickets, he won the cross this year. And you'll only see him working on the left side in competition. But both these dogs need to work on the left and the right. So Pogo's on the right, and what we're going to do now is we're going to half twist them onto the other side. Pogo, twist.
Okay, in a minute.
So now Levi is going to work on the right, and Pogo onto the left. They've got to be able to, in Heelwork music, work on both sides. So that we're flexible, as you just saw, we did a link move there, which was a half twist. We'll go back again, Mary, twist again. Good, right. Good. Now notice the attention the dogs are giving us.
Yeah. Okay.
That's really important. The attention, the dog needs to be looking at us for perhaps 4 or 5 minutes when me and Mary do our best in show routines. The dogs have got to be focused. There's lots of things going on around the ring. So, Levi's just going to do some heel work. I'm going to show you what his attention is like. So I'm going to try and distract Levi as he's walking along with my dog. So, we're going to see what superb attention Levi has. Now he's a ticket dog, he's won the cross. So we're going to see what we can do. So we're going to run around. Walk back, oh, walk back, twist. We're doing lots of exciting things. Work with my dog really close. One way, run with us, run with us, run with us. Again, he's got to remain attention. Now that's the level of attention you need. I think that gives Levi a round of applause. Everything you can see comes from obedience. And that's so important when we're working with dogs. But let's show you a few other little fun things that we do with the dogs. Now you can see these are both border collies, Daryl. And you've probably seen the border collie on one man and his dog. The sheep are there. The dogs run straight towards them, push them into the pen. So we use this manoeuvre of a creep to get the dog down to do a creep move within our routines. But it's no good, we were just doing it there beside us. We want the dog to try and creep on a little bit, lie down. Now to do that, what we might do, wait there, Pogo, wait. Wait, I said wait. Right, because she knows what's coming. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put my ball out there. He's looking at the ball as well. Lie down, it's going to be who gets there first. Wait, wait, wait. Lie down. Right, so what I was going to say was, Hulk, come back here, is we put the ball out there as an attraction for the dog to go. Because what we want the dog to do now, Dan, is not have anything out there, but actually go on its own. So that's a way that we can advance the creep move that we had beside me. Sorry, Hulk. So we're going to try and get the creep forward. I don't know whether Levi does this, but okay. Right, down, creep on. Down, 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 creep. Down, creep. Down, creep. We should put that in a routine. Look, they're both going around down the creek. Good. You're going to creep back to me now, are you? Good. Give them a little round of applause. Very nice.
Okay, in a minute.
Right. Okay, so there's a little creep. Right. Okay, so there's a little Greek move. Now we've also got little paw moves that we do. Now you might have taught your dogs to do your paw moves. Sit. Thank you. At home. Now all you do is you pick the paw up and give the dog a treat. Okay, and he... a reward when it puts its paw on your hand. Now we can now make this into a foot target by placing our hand onto our lower leg. We teach the dog to raise its foot and touch our foot. Okay, just by putting our hand down there, the dog gets used to touching our foot and then we don't need to use our hand. But we like to take this one stage further, don't we, Mary? Okay, but we do things for a little bit more advanced. Three-legged walk. Right. So what we do is we teach the dog first of all to stand with one foot in the air. Then we ask the dog to take one, two, three steps forward. It's got to balance itself, so it's very advanced. It does take a while for the dog to gain that balance. You want to face straight ahead, Mary? We'll do it together. Right, so in a routine, Pogo, hop, hop. We might hop the dogs together. We now hop. Notice their tails wagging, they're enjoying themselves. That's so important there. Give them a little round of applause. Last little one we're going to do is a little bit of fun. Using the dog's back leg. I hope Levi does back leg, doesn't he? Quick bit. Oh, wait there. Look, he's a male, you see. Lie down. Can you see what he's doing with his back leg? He's just touching me with his back leg, and then he cocks his leg on me. Look like that. What we do is we use something for the dog to put its leg on when we're training it. So that's why Mary wanted my leg there, to get the dog to put its leg on my leg. And then what we do is we start to... Now bear in mind mine's a little girl, so she's not used to doing a back leg up. We start to put it on a visual signal, in my case. So when she sees my leg go up, she does the same. And that's one more advanced thing that we do as a routine, because when you watch us doing our routines, we try not to speak to the dogs as much. What we want to do is put certain parts of the routine on a body signal. Can you do it? Show us again. He's thinking about it. It's got a front leg. It can't quite decide which back leg to put up. I think he needs me here. Put your back leg up, mate. There you go, we got it. routine at 1:40 in the main ring if you want to come and watch us there. Thank you very much.